This is your girl, Tricia S, host of the Color of Love show every Saturday and every Sunday, 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. Don't forget to follow us on all our social media. You heard it at Hit USA Radio. We gon' vibe, if only for an hour, right here.
USA Radio.
You heard it. The radio station that's in the community. Don't go nowhere. Online marketing is not a trend. Many companies have closed their doors because of COVID-19. But some of those same companies transitioned into a new type of business and discovered the power and effectiveness of having an online marketing strategy. Hit USA Radio recognizes that the future of a business is dependent upon an online marketing strategy. Hit USA Radio has a marketing package at an affordable price point that focuses on strategies that will reach your targeted demographics, increase website traffic, increase followers and engagement on your social media platforms, content strategy and creation, social media posting, analytics and a sales funnel, and creating and converting leads. If you'd like more information about our online marketing packages, send an email to info@hitusaradio.com. Good afternoon, everybody. This is your girl, Tricia S., host of the Color of Love show. And I told y'all I was going to have some heat. I told you guys that I was. I am here today on a Saturday with a whole Renaissance man. Okay, he really is. And his name is none other than Bobby Lokey. What's up, Bobby Lokey?
How you doing there? How you doing there, sir? How's it going?
It's going great, and I'm so excited to share you with my Hit USA Radio listeners. Well, you know what? I'm going to say my Tricia S. Color of Love listeners.
Yeah.
All right, so to start, tell me about your brand name, because I think it's a dope name, Bobby Lokey. Where did that come from?
Okay, well, Bobby Lokey came from the music industry. I used to travel and do marketing with different artists. I perform myself. So a while back, like when we were younger, me and some of the entertainers that I used to run around with,
yes,
we all different names, like street names and things like that. But as we evolved, I had a partner named Showtime, who was actually a great actor, a beautiful singer. Like, this guy, he's amazing.
Wow.
He said, he has so many talents, you real low key. And it just changed the name, so it just stuck with me. And, you know, it's been with me for a long time. I've actually updated my name, the brand name Bobby, which is designer name.
Okay, but, okay.
The artist name still is alive. I still have people who the name of me for what I do in the music world. So it was a look.
Yeah, and you really do have so many talents. And the thing about it is you perform every last one of those with a spirit of perfection. Where they do that at?
In the black world. We done had a hard road, so if we're not putting forth the effort to be great and be masters at the things that we do, we are subpar, and that just don't work for me. And I like to teach that and preach that to not only my kids, but the people I introduce myself to, and I come around. So it's like a growth thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I completely understand, because as an African-American woman, it's a double whammy. You just got to show up. You can't
just talk about it. You got to be about it. And as two African-American people, we understand that we just have to do way better than our counterparts, people that are not of color. That's an unfortunate thing, but I think it gives us a bit of grit. Don't you think?
Because this is the future. It's not like we in the past. Even though through the election and things like that, we've seen a lot of racism that still exists in this world. But it's a lot of non-black people who love us, who we love. And I think like the growth needs to be the bridge that meets everybody together, because that's our biggest problem. It's working together as not only as a unit as black people, but as a humane thing.
Exactly. I do agree with you on that. We do need to get to a point where we celebrate our differences and we can come together as a people. But on that note, it's about you. This is all about you. So, because you have a lot of things, a lot of great things going on, we're going to go back to the beginning in 2008 when you created a company. And you go ahead and tell my listeners what the name of that company was and what were you doing at that time.
Okay, well, back then, 2008, like I said, as young entrepreneurs, musicians, and all, we were evolving. And I had decided to go back to school and learn about business management because I was so deep into it, just freestyling my way through. They taught me about things like building a business, marketing, things like that. So when I went back out in the field, I'm like, okay, I'm going to be the next. That's gonna show out, you know, that people gonna know it's us and they gonna love it. So Respect Entertainment came into play. And entertainment was nothing more than just people from my city who I was loving, and I would promote, I would rent out clubs and do shows. It was a beautiful thing. We got so many different people who grew from just that one life experience.
Oh, you know? Wow. Okay. And I see that a lot of people, I discovered a lot of people that you work with, Do or Die, Twister, Jeremiah, Ben One, Bushwick Bill. You have a great resume, and you know, on your background.
Yeah, due to my collaboration with the people I've always worked with, I've always been able to become a person who walks right into circles with confidence. It's just the presence of wanting to see other people do great things.
Right.
That's all.
Okay, well, on that note, we're going to have to take a break right here so I can get those people that pay our bills a chance to do they thing. But Tricia S. Loves, don't y'all leave. Stay right here. We got some great stuff coming up from my guest. He is off the chain. You're going to want to hear more of his backstory.
It's that time of year again. Radical Al is giving away money.
Say what?
Yep. What do you have to do, you ask? Well, let me tell you. First, you have to follow us on Instagram at HitUSA Radio. Second, you have to listen for Radical Al's top 5 songs on the Radical Al Afternoon Drive Show, Monday through Friday from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. Then you call in. Where do you call in? 312-530-9581. What do you leave on the hotline? Well, you say your name, list the top 5, a phone number where you can be reached, and that's it. Good luck, and thanks for being a HitUSA Radio listener.
So, hey, Tricia S. Loves, we are back here with my guest, Bobby Lokey. So we can go ahead and get right into it. Now, there was a time where you weren't feeling your best self, and you said it was because you were feel like you weren't living out your passion. Could you tell us a little bit more about that? Because I really want to hear that.
Okay, well, the truth with that is more or less like when you growing in this world, and especially as a black man, and you have children, and you wanna be able to take care of those kids. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
But you you also have your passions, your aspirations, and those things change when people have children. A lot of people don't know that. It's a struggle for an artist who is trying to pay his bills, take care of his family, and live his dream at the same time, because they all cost.
They do.
Sometimes you're going to have to sacrifice, and I made a lot of sacrifices, so, you know, one of them was I had stopped performing and traveling a lot because I had children.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to soul seek, so I really was like a gangster rapper. So I was like, man, I don't want my daughter listening to me talk about it and exploit women the way I be saying this. So I didn't want to put that music in the world no more. You know, that it was a lot of changes for me.
Wow. And I want to commend you on that, Bobby Lokey, because I am sort of the same way. I am the same way. There's no sort of about it. Like, I write as well. You and my backgrounds are kind of the same. And when I write, I can write the trap, you know, and the crazy, dirty stuff. But when I promote myself, I want to put things that are uplifting into people's ears. You know what I'm saying? So I really do appreciate this medium that I have access to be able to do that. So, yeah, that's a great thing. And then the fact that you are a full-time father that is in your children's lives. We're going to uplift you right here on Tricia's Color of Love show. And it's sad that we have to do that, but we want to uplift our brothers because it just doesn't happen enough. So I am proud of you for just that one thing, because that's important, being a father and being in their lives for real, for real.
Yeah.
So, yeah, kudos to you on that. So, yeah, we all, us women out there, we appreciate that, because, you know, we talk a lot about our brothers, but there's some good ones out there. There still is. So, yeah, but I also was impressed by the fact that you decided to work with your children's mom on a project that she had going on. Tell me a little bit about that.
Oh, yeah, that's a non-profit, Cody's Closet. It's a children's thrift store where pretty much where we give to the community in a way of donations. People donate to us, so in order to operate, we sell the clothes back to them for a very little price, $2, $3 for pants and shirts, $5 for the shoes. But we offer things for the community, like enlist the children to read. We help them with like class stuff sometimes. In the Halloween party, so many different things that we try to do for the community, being a small organization, but with a large heart.
Wow, that's incredible. So where is this Cody's Closet located at?
Well, it's actually located on the south side of Chicago, 1259 West 79th Street,
mm-hmm.
right on 7th Street, across from the Renaissance Park. We're just opening up over here. It's a new location. Cottage Grove. Yeah, we was there first. And we did a lot for that community, unfortunately, due to the COVID thing and, you know, stipulations. We had to move the location. But, you know, we're blessed to be on 79th. There's a lot going on here that we're part of. Father Blake is not too far from us, so we're looking forward to working with him and his church on doing things with the community and so much more.
Oh, I love it. So if somebody, like, do you guys take donations, clothing and stuff like that? If they were interested in that, would they just, do you guys have a phone number, an email? Because that's great.
Oh, yeah, we definitely do. They could definitely call the number 312-890-9855 in order to make a donation. We ask that most of the clothes be gently used. You know,
right.
They look real. Because we want to make sure that a family in need, that they kids, they going to school, not right now because, you know, they're doing the e-learning, but they outside, they confidence level is high. We want to make sure we give our people good stuff. So, yeah, they can send it to there. If they wanted to do the email, they can email us at codysclosetthirtyfive@gmail.com. I'm going to spell that out so people know exactly how it's spelled, which is KODIKLOSET35@gmail.com. And so that people know, my kid's mom, her name is Monique Ali. She started this with a heart of being involved with this in her own. You know what I mean?
Like, right.
So raising 7 children and going through the situation of having to know the burden of making sure that all your kids are dressed and that they appropriate for their lifestyle that they want to live. You know, she wants that same thing for the world. And that's what made this happen. This started down at Bread of Life Church. It was done in the basement, and it grew from there.
Wow.
So it's a blessing to have that type of that motivation, just to have somebody who feels something for themselves and know that the world suffers the same.
Right. I exactly know what you mean. And I'm going to say it here right on the station, y'all. I am in love with you and your wife. You hear me?
That's my kid's mama. She already met it.
Well, we ain't gonna do none of that, you know, Jada Pinkett and Will Smith thing. Ain't about all that. But I really, I'm just impressed by what you guys are doing. And I actually have some clothes, and they are nice clothes. They're gently worn that I would like to donate. And if you guys that are listening, go ahead and follow me and call them, email them. He gave you the information. Send them the clothes or see if you can drop them off, whatever you have to do. If you have some nice, gently worn clothing, don't bring no trash. Don't bring no trash. Because you know you don't want your children to wear trash. But anyhow, drop them off. Now, with me, most of my clothes, therefore, they were mine.
Usually when we get adult clothing, we make sure they get to places like the women's shelter, the men's shelter, stuff like that. So it goes where it needs to go.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, I have clothes, shoes, and a couple of coats. But anyhow, moving on. You were working at FedEx. Tell me how all of that feel like. How did that come to play and you were doing all this other stuff? Give me some insight into that, because looking at your stuff make my head spin, bro.
I donated a lot of my time to FedEx as far as learning. That to me, that place was really like a institution that built me to be the machine that I am right now, because I had to do so many different things. When I got there, I came from being a security guard who actually my company had phased out. And through the gracious blessings of God, the people who worked at the church where I did security saw how good I was, and the lady was the supervisor or manager of FedEx downtown at the time.
Wow.
And she was like, well, yeah, she said, I know you're losing your job. Would you ever think about working for FedEx? I said, well, I don't know nothing about that stuff, you know. She's like, well, if you want it, come on. And I came because I needed a check. So I'm like, a lady by the name of Sharon Dyson wound up being my manager at the time. And she was a great manager. I mean, like, she took her time with me. She was patient, but she wasn't patient because I was really messing it up because I didn't know what I was doing. It's just like, hey, your stuff messed up. Hey, you better figure this out. I can't keep showing you. And I'm like, oh, Lord, I can't lose this job.
Right. So you ended up learning it, like, self-teaching and really getting it together.
Fast and quick. And then after that, I just started expanding. From there, I wound up working at every store downtown for FedEx.
Oh, my God.
Working on the machine if I needed to take it down and put the ink together. So really, they blessed me by giving me all these skills and making it possible
right.
to do my own graphics and learn how to use that stuff, because it all came to play with everything else, because I was already taking pictures, because I was taking pictures of everybody that performed and videoing people. So all that stuff just, you know, it just balled
wow.
up in one. Made me a super
meat,
you know?
Oh, yeah, I get it. Trust me. But on that note, we're going to take a break, take a pause for the calls, and we'll be back, you guys. Thank you for listening here on www.hitusaradio.com.
Hit USA Radio.
My name is Brand Name Bobby. And I listen to HitUSARadio.com, the station that's in the community.
So we are back here at the Tricia S. Color of Love show. And we gonna get into some music with Bobby Lokey. He do everything. I'm surprised he hasn't built a plane by now. Have you built a plane? You know how to build a plane?
I
believe you. I truly do, sir. But anyhow, now you're here currently putting on that artist hat. So what's up with that? I checked out your Instagram. You was, you know, kicking a little beat. What you doing? What you got?
Well, just warming up. I'm still with the same people pretty much. We didn't evolve, basically. So right now I'm working with Blue Cheese Ricky, BCG, Blue Cheese Gang, which is a media production company. I also work with Rio de Janeiro, who is a producer, a studio engineer, and great artist of his own stature. Y'all should check them out. But yeah, so I'm working on my artistry right now, grooming myself, you know, seeing what the world has and where they are. And I see a lot of the drill music and a lot of the death. I'm not really focused on that type of lifestyle, but, you know, like, as a message, I would like for them to understand that what you speak, you get. And I pray that, you know, people who have lost their lives in this music industry, that they families, they heal.
Right.
But me, I'm trying to make music that build people, you know, that make them feel good, give them that understanding of life. So that's where I'm headed with it, and I'm in the studio. I'm writing right now, hanging out with Saint the Good Boy. He is an inspirational beat maker, engineer, you know. So it's like a lot of things that's going on that's for me, that I've always wanted to do, and now that I'm in a position to make myself comfortable and live the life I want to live, I'm going to live it.
Wow, you know what? I swear you in my brain, brother. I swear you are. Because that's the same with me. Because I feel like whatever you say, you can either speak life or speak death. But both of them will happen, especially if you keep chanting it. You know what I'm saying? Keep saying it. So I'm very particular and very specific about things that I say about my life on a consistent basis. Because I know that I can speak death and I can speak life, and I've had, I have evidence of it in my life. So I'm very careful about doing that. So is there a place where anybody can go if they wanted to hear your music? You know what? We ain't going to say if. They're going to want to hear your music. Where would you send them?
All they got to do is type in Bobby Lokey or Bobby Lokey Newman. I'm going to pop up on Google. I'm going to be places. So if you put that in or type in brand name Bobby, I'm going to pop up. So whenever you look, you need some clothes made, you need some graphics done, you need a video shot, you type my name in, you send me a message. I'm a humble person. I'm going to work with you. I'm going to make sure that you eat. I'm going to make sure that we live.
Did y'all hear that? He just said, Google me. I feel you, though. Google him. So, this has been an enjoyable interview, and I want to give you the opportunity to share with our listeners here at Hit USA Radio something that you want. What would you leave them with about who is Bobby Lokey? Like something. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
I said you had already put it in the flyer, Serial Entrepreneur. I'm here to kill it all. And I ain't talking about in depth. I'm talking about in bringing life with every infrastructure of Chicago. We done lost too many. So I'm here to be a leader, you know, not a follower. I'm here to make sure that people understand that we need to educate each other and build with one another. So that's my gift to the world, actually. So, but if you'll let me throw one more thing in there.
Throw it in.
I want to let the world know I'm coming with a TV show. Well, it's going to be episoded on YouTube. Hopefully, we can get it on Netflix or something like that. But the brand name Bobby Show, where I show the existence of great people in this world, business, life, entertainment, life, comedy, like whatever angle we're going to go in, we're going to be there. And I want you to know you got a lot of great things coming. Just look forward to it.
Okay, I'm going to hold you to that. But on that note, guys, it was a blessing to have him here. We're going to go ahead and get on out of here. Thank you guys for joining me here at the Color of Love show. And come back, because this will be aired on the website for 2 weeks. But then you guys will be able to hear it as often as you want on my podcast. But that'll be in 2 weeks. Again, guys, thank you so much. And I love you and be blessed.